the glue on it. The goal is to get it to 0.045. I'm gonna accept that actually. I'm just going to trim it flush with the shaft, get as close as possible, and then trim it with a blade. Tap on this to zoom in, to focus on it if it needs to be focused. Alright, let's see here. try this at home. Don't try this at home, guys. If you're not comfortable doing it with a blade, do it however you see fit. But I feel like I get more control and I can feel the highs and the lows with this. And I, you know, I've done this for a long time, so don't try to copy this method unless you are very experienced with this. Switching my tool post out, just putting a block stock on there to give me something to trim off of. I'm just gonna do like a dime radius on this. Now again, I don't have a guide for this, but I've been doing this for a long time. I just know what a dime is. Again, this just takes time to be able to do it without a guide. And we'll take a 100 grit sandpaper. I'm going to level the edges off, and I kind of wrap it around the radius to do this, and it just kind of naturally takes and evens everything out if there is any imperfections in it. And I don't take the crown off by doing this. Alright. Now everything's somewhat true and trim on this custom ferrule. But now it's time to get that luster shine out of it. So I'm going to, there's some blade marks in it. So I'm going to take this to 220 grit, and then 400, then 800, and 1200, then I'm going to polish it out. So I'm going to go ahead and stop the video on this part because it's hard to get up in here with this. But I'll come back on a second when it's done. All right, so now I'm going to go ahead and buff this out. Just some automotive buffing compound. Polishing out clear coat basically. It does the same thing for acrylic based products or anything else essentially that you want to get to a nice buff. Well, let's get a little bit more in here. This is an emerald green ferrule. Sorry about the shaking. My arm's a little tired from working all day. It's an emerald green to match a green Q-Tech hue. Turned out really sharp with a fluorescent green shock pad and a tiger emerald green tip. So it really flows good.
It's going to turn out beautiful next to the Q-Tech Q.